Hey everyone, how is it going? In this tutorial, we'll create urban cover art design in Gimp. Let's begin. Alright, first go to File, New, and I set to the size. This is the common size for the social media post. Just hit OK. And change the color to black. So click this barcode filter. And make sure the black is selected. And just click it. And let's bring up our texture by going to File, open this layer, and just this. Scale it up by pressing Shift S and hold Ctrl Shift while scaling to make it proportional and press Enter. Change in layer mode to Grain Extract. Adjust the curve to make it appear by going to Color, Curves. Just turn it down around this and hit OK. You can turn down the opacity, this is too much. You can slide it down around this. Bring up the picture by going to File, open this layer, and just this. Let's click Convert. Scale it down by pressing Shift S and hold Ctrl Shift while scaling. Right around this and press Enter. You see the texture applied to the picture. Alright, with text tool, click this icon and type, change the font to, and increase the size and change the color to some pink color. Place it on here. Duplicate again for the stroke. So on this layer, click this icon. Just drag it down and hold Ctrl Shift while moving. Let's make it become stroke by going to right click, all parts selection, and go to select, choose shrink, make it by 2, and just press delete. Don't forget to select none by going to select and choose none, or the shortcut is Shift Ctrl A. That's how you make text a stroke in Gimp. Let's change it to white color with curves by going to color, curves, and just make it up till it's white and hit OK. Duplicate one more. Hold Ctrl Shift while moving. You see in my previous video how to make stacked text in Inkscape, it's easier to do that with the interpolate. But in Gimp, we have to adjust it manually to make it precise step. Let's add more text here with text tool. Type, change it to white color, change the font to, and reduce the size, and you can adjust the spacing like this. And I just bring up the ruler, just drag it to make it precise to the text on here. With move tool, just move it, it will automatically snap like this. Alright, you can turn off the ruler by going to view and click the show guides, or the shortcut is this. Create some rectangle here, create new layer and name it rectangle, and with rectangle tool click this, make it around this, make it become white color by going to edit and fill with background color, because my background color is currently white. Don't forget to deselect it by going to select and choose none. Let's type again some text with text tool. Change the color to white. Change the font to, make the size to, and change the color to this pink. And press Shift R to rotate it. And hold Ctrl Shift while rotating. And click this rotate. Move it down to here. And just do the same like this. Duplicate and make the stroke. So I'm just gonna duplicate it. Move it to here. And I just changed the first text with white by going to color, curves, and just make it up. move the layer to the top of the stroke. I'm going to move the new release text slightly to the right. So the easy way to do that, you can make it link and choose the one linked layer. Just move it to the right. Next, let's create a circle text in here. Let's find the ellipse select. Alright. Hold Ctrl Shift while creating the circle to make it proportional scale around this. And while in selection like this, go to select and choose to path. So you see now it's creating a new path in here. While in selection like this, let's type and change it to white color. Change the font to big in layer again. And right click, choose text along path. So you see the text is really big for the circle. You can undo it by pressing Ctrl Z. And let's try to change to 35. Let's try to put it again by going to right click, choose text along path. Let's create a new layer on the top. Name it. Now let's just deselect it by going to select and choose none. So now on the path, you see these two paths, one for the circle text and the circle only. Just make it become selection by going to right click, path to selection. And on the circle text layer, just fill it by going to edit, fill with background color. Alright, don't forget to deselect it. And back on the path again, you can turn off this visibility to make it clear. Next, we're going to create the circle stroke by creating new layer and name it. On the path again, let's make it become white color. You can swap it to bring up the white color in the front and turn on this visibility. Right click, choose stroke path. Just make it by 2 solid color. Then just hit stroke. You see now in the circle stroke for the circle only and this for the circle text. So just cut some of the path with bezier tool, press B and just make it here. When almost finished, hold Ctrl, you see this chain icon, then click and press enter. Then you just erase it with the eraser tool, click this. Make sure you're in the circle stroke layer and just erase it. Alright, deselect it by pressing Ctrl Shift A. You can turn off this visibility. Now you can delete the previous text and add some elements here by going to File, open this layer, and adjust this. Scale it down by pressing Shift S, hold Ctrl Shift while scaling, and place it on this. Make it become white because it's in the black color. You just invert it by going to Color, choose Invert. If you want to change some vector object to another color, example red, blue, or this pink, you can see my previous video, the Stephen Curry poster. I put some example how to change this vector object to another color. You can scale down this entire element by make it link like before. And don't forget to remove this link because if you don't remove it, it will follow this scale it too. So make sure you link the right objects. So I just press Shift S to scale it down. Add more elements. We're going to File, open this layer, and adjust this duct tape. Press Shift S to scale it down. And place it on here. You can rotate it a little by hitting Shift R. And just play with layer mode. I want to change to pin like. That's dope. Add again by going to File, open this layer, and adjust this. And scale it down. Play with layer mode, change to pin like. Okay, we are almost finished. Make some torn paper brush effect with brush tool. And I change my brush to this torn paper effect. You can download and install in the link description. I put explanation how to install that. It's really easy. Just click that. You see it's horizontal right now, you can turn up the angle to make some rotation and create new layer and name it Torn Paper Effect and hit OK. Just click it to make some torn paper effect. And you can try with Eraser tool too to make some variation like this. Add more. Add barcode here by going to file, open this layer and just this. Just hit convert. Then just bring up to the top and scale it down by hitting Shift S. Hold Ctrl Shift while scaling. Place it to here. You can try the turn effect in here too with eraser tool like this. And you can change the size and the angle. Just click it. Make it upside down, change the rotation. Let's move this to here. Let's cut it down a little. And I just add some text here. Scale it down. You can change the spacing. Last thing, we're going to create the grain effect. So create new layer, animate grain. Just hit OK. And make it become black color with barcode fill tool. Click this. And just swap this. And just click it to here. Go to filter, noise, and this EHV noise. You can try to increase the dulling and the value. Just try the settings. Just hit OK. Change layer mode to screen. If it's too much, you can turn on the opacity. Run this. That's it. Hope you learned something new, how to create an album cover design, Spotify podcast cover art, or just social media posts with your urban style concept like this. Keep exploring and keep practicing so you have more references and make it better. I'm Zeki from Zeki Design. Create something good today. Thanks for watching.